Hi everyone, welcome back to Sesame and Puff. Today we'll talk about the latest possible treatment for FIP and how we can prevent it in the first place. If you haven't checked out our first two videos on FIP, please go to the link here on top.
Treatment, the GS441.
Before 2019, Feline infectious peritonitis was a guaranteed death sentence for cats. 10 out of 10 cats die of it, and there isn't much humans can do about it. Until 2019, Dr. Pedersen of UC Davis had found a quotation cure for feline infectious peritonitis, the GS441524.
The nucleoside analog GS441524 is a molecular precursor to a pharmacologically active nucleoside trisphosphate molecule. These analogs, once metabolized by the host, become an alternative substrate for ATP and act as a viral RNA-dependent RNA polymerase inhibitor, targeting the viral genome replication process. When the virus cannot replicate itself and multiply, it cannot cause much sickness and will eventually be resolved by the body. If a cat's immune system is healthy and mature, the white blood cell should fight off an infection, in this case from a virus, and allow the cat to build up an immune response by producing antibodies. Cats who develop FIP have an immune defect or deficiency that causes the white blood cells to replicate rather than fight the virus. Essentially, the cat's immune system is spreading the virus throughout the cat's body rather than trying to eliminate it. Cats who have no immune response develop wet FIP, while cats with partial immune response develop dry FIP. GS441 comes in both injectable form and a pill form. Both are administered daily and the dose is based on the weight of the cat. Clinical trials suggested the whole course be 84 days in total.
The drug is not approved by the FDA for FIP right now, but there are black markets selling it as far as we know. Since the drug is still not officially available, vets cannot give it to your cat directly.
For more information, you can contact your vet first and also check out Facebook FIP groups. Drug controversies. Unlike bacteria, which we can kill easily with different antibiotics, we have very limited antiviral drugs. As we can already see with the antibiotics we have right now, resistance in microorganisms can emerge very quickly, and hence we have to pay special attention to when and how we use the limited drugs we have right now. With that in mind, we cannot say for sure that the drug will eventually be registered for FIP treatment someday later. How is the drug related to COVID-19? As you may already know, the virus for this pandemic is a coronavirus. FIP, on the other hand, is a coronavirus as well. Given both of the viruses are from the same virus family, drug that works on FIP may also work on COVID-19.
While there are research working on it and trying to find whether GS441425 and its prodrug, the remdesivir GS5734, can work against coronavirus in humans, the drug's registration for FIP in cats is very likely to be halted, especially if clinical trials suggest that the COVID-19 is susceptible to these two drugs and we have to preserve them for human use only.
How to prevent FIP or feline coronavirus in general? Feline coronavirus is a common infection in cats, especially in multi-cat environments. The feline coronavirus transmission occurs by the fecal-oral route and requires the presence of feline coronavirus-infected cats to shed the virus in their feces. A previous research demonstrated that 13% of the cats exposed to feline coronavirus become lifelong carriers and continually shed virus in their feces. Most other cats are only transiently infected, and after a period of months, they eliminate infection and stop shedding virus. A small number of cats appear to be resistant and never become infected. Owners may do the following to minimize the risk of FIP. 1. Avoid keeping large groups of cats and having multiple litters of kittens at any one time. 2. Keep cats in small isolated groups, ideally not more than 4 cats in each group. This reduces the risk of endemic feline coronavirus infection. 3. Have at least 1 litter box for every 2 cats, located in easy to clean and disinfect areas. 4. Keep litter boxes away from food and water bowls. Clean and disinfect them regularly, at least daily. A commercial vaccine is available in some countries to help protect against FIP. However, the vaccine, while showing some efficacy, can only be given to kittens over 16 weeks of age. But given most kittens in high-risk households would already have been exposed to feline coronavirus by 16 weeks of age, the vaccine probably has little or no value.
That's all we have for feline coronavirus. If you like our videos, please subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you next week. Bye!